this kind of machine, and there's an initial state and there's a final state also, but there is no arc. So definitely language should be shy. So Sha is a particular language, there is no accepted string is there. There it is a Q0, and definitely this is a non-deterministic FSM, but anything can be accepted. So that is a epsilon, in some books there is a lambda, it will be accepted. Here, the initial state is Q0, the final state is QF, only symbol A, you can go to the final state. So A is the part of the lambda. Take a MCQ question, what is the relation between DFA and NFA on the basis of computational power? I have taken again and again, they should be equal. But it will be shown that whenever in push-down automata, non-deterministic push-down automata has more power. Power means more expressive power. Power doesn't mean it does it quickly. No, power means here whether it can absorb more language. Like deterministic push-down automata can only take the balance parenthesis on a to the power n, b to the power n, but non-deterministic PDA can accept your palindrome. Yeah. So here, answer is equal. That non-deterministic PDA question will come later. Here, L is the language of all strings of equal number of zeros and ones. If it is, say, this is the definition of the language, which string is fitted? Here we see this will be auto. You can always omit it out because no epsilon is there. Because I see all the strings have equal number of zeros and ones. So if there is 00 occasion occurrence, that is also nothing is there. It should be accepted. Like epsilon should be accepted. So here epsilon is not there. So the choice is between this and this. Here you see here true it is now equal number of zeros and ones. Then here you see strictly zero come first and one comes later, but here all the combinations are there. So this should be the correct answer. Which of the following is the correct proposition? Statement 1, non-determinism is the generalization of determinism. And statement 2, every DFA is automatically an NFA. Statement 2 is correct because statement 1 is correct. If you think carefully, this should be your answer. Others will not be answered. What is the wrong of the definition of NFA? See here, Q is there and Q consists of Q0, Q1 and Q2, and final state is here, it is here, Q3. Q3 doesn't belong to Q. So that is absent. That cannot be. Even in DFA and NDFA, final state acceptance should be part of Q0. So initial and final state do not belong to Q. So here initial state is Q0 and Q, so it is not belong to, so this should be the answer. Yeah, what is the transition function, you know? The transition function Q is the number of states and this is the alphabet, it's a Cartesian product and it must go to the Q itself. If you see others, it is should be the wrong. It should be the states and the Cartesian product. So it any symbol of the alphabet and it should go to the Q also. So this should be your correct answer, transition function maps of any finite state machine. If machine accepts no strings, it recognizes, yeah, that is one language called empty language. It is a part of generally most of the languages, empty language is always taken. And empty language means everything is that empty, anything is accepted, but empty variable is generally the start variable. I repeat, I mentioned in our earlier lecture also that it should be start variable goes to epsilon. No other variable can go to epsilon. If it is there, you have to modify that grammar. You can modify. No other variable, because if it is any other variable can go to epsilon, the mod means length of left hand side and mod length of right hand side, length of right hand side must be greater than equal to. If any variable other than start variable can go to the right, then maybe length of the right hand side may be less than left hand side. length of the left hand side. That is type 0 language. So if the machine accepts no string, I have told you it should be empty language. Number of final states required to accept shy, that is nothing is accepted in minimal state automata, none of them mentioned. It should be none of them. Just think of it. NFA in its name has non-deterministic because of choice of path is non-deterministic, not others, OPs. This is a bit tougher question. This is I say L1, 0 to the power P, 1 to the power Q, P, Q, N, E. So it's a regular grammar. Definitely regular grammar. No relation between P and Q. Here, what is this? 0 to the power P, 1 to the power Q, P, Q, P equal to Q. So definitely, this is a context free, deterministic context free grammar. So L2 is a deterministic context free. This is regular grammar. What is this? 0 to the power P, 1 to the power Q, 1 to the power R, P, Q, P is equal to, this is a context sensitive grammar. The context sensitive grammar. Which of the following statement is not true? But which of the following statements are not true? All the three languages are context. This is a not true. This is a false. Why? Why? I have told this is regular grammar, 100%. This is deterministic context free grammar, a to the power n, b to the power n. This is a to the power n, b to the power n. P and Q are different. And here, P equal to Q equal to R. Definitely, it is a context sensitive grammar. Okay. So, all the three languages are context free. This is definitely. This should be a correction. Okay, this is a good question. We have the five. Does a given program ever produce an output? This is a basically nothing but Turing halting problem I discussed. Any program sometimes fails in output. So this is one is a variation of Turing machine halting problem, and it is undecided. This is undecidable problem. I want which of the following problems are decided. Does a given program ever produce output? That is definitely a Turing halting problem. Then comes, if L is a context-free language, then the complement of A are also, this is very good proposition that as per the closer relation, I have told you, this regular grammar complement is a regular grammar, but context-free complement, it is undetermined. So, this is also not true. So, remaining is 3 and 4. What is the 3? If L is a regular language, then is complement regular? True. Because all the operation, complement, intersection, all are regular. All are regular. So, that is true. All closer relationships are okay. And this is, I have not started a class in the recursive language. That is a general type 1, type 0 language. Then complement also are recursive. That is true. So, this is another cover, but answer is 3 and 4. So, first, a beginning, this one is a Turing halting problem. I have a little bit of discussion. That's it. And complement of complement and intersection of context free language is not context free language. It can be regular, it can be context free, it depends. So, it is not a closer relationship. Which of the following is false? There is a unique minimal DFA for every language, every regular language. What is the false? Deterministic PDA, which cannot handle language of grammars with ambiguity. Correct. So which of the following is a false? There is a unique minimal ID. This is true. Every NFA can be converted. This is every NFA. Every NFA can be converted to equivalent PDA. So come to this. Complement of every context-free language is recursive. No, this is false. This is false. Every non-deterministic PDA can be converted to. This is absolutely wrong. So non-deterministic PDA cannot be converted to the equivalent deterministic PDA that I have told you, like palindrome, because when after pushing, when has to be popping, and so that it matches. That is a palindrome, that is non-deterministic PDA. Deterministic PDA is A to the power N, B to the power N. Again, I mentioned because you know when the A, whenever A is coming, N times, you push them, and you know now B is coming, then pop A, and pop each A and B matches, then you go along. But in palindrome detection, you do not know where the midpoint comes. Okay? So every non-deterministic PDA can be converted to equivalent deterministic PDA. This one is a false answer. Okay? So that's it. Yeah, a little explanation of this. Yeah, this I got. Yeah, just a little bit expression of Moore machine and Mealy machine. You see there is no final state here, though it is a FSM. You may have final state, may not final state, because actually Moore machine and Mealy machine, we are interested in one kind of output with every transition. So if it is, comes with the transition, we call it a Mealy machine, and after transition it go to a state, stable state. From the state, you come to know what is the output. That is a Moore machine. That is a Moore machine. And it is a 6 tuple. Here you see this is output. Delta is the input matrix, sigma is the alphabet, and delta is the input, output is this. This is Mealy machine. Here the output is given by, you always see the here by slash. It can be 0, 1, it can be another alphabet also. Generally, it's another alphabet. See, now the question is. Now the question is that which of the following are correct? Moon machine has 6 tuples, yes. Mealy machine has 6 tuples, Mealy machine, yes. Both Mealy and Moore has 6 tuples, yes. Correct. So this is the right option. Moon machine has an application of non-finite automata with output. Finite automata without input, finite automata with output. Non-finite automata with output. So it should be, the answer is, this question answer is finite automata, because definitely it's a finite automata. Except state, it can be there, but it is not generally Moore and Mealy machine, there is no except state, only state transition. So it will be, the answer is finite automata without. The in Mealy machine, output depends on state and input. In Moore machine, only state, and in Mealy machine, state and input. In Moore machine, output is produced over the change of states, definitely. In Mealy machine, it will be along with the inputs. Input state and the transition. So it is a state. Moore machine always state. So for designing a Moore machine for Mealy machine, you may have more number of state, but it may be slower also. Mealy machine is faster, but it is the one problem with it can, any input glitch, it can suddenly give different output. So Moore machine is that way stable. Output of Mealy machine can be represented in the following format. This is the format, output with input. These both the methods, both the functions are there. The ratio of number of input to number of output in Mealy machine is 1, and for Moore machine it will be n into 8 plus 1. Mealy and Moore machine can be categorized as transducers, because this convert from output is convert. Definitely not Turing machine. Inducer is just to confuse you. Linear bounded automata is a Turing machine with left and right hand side bounded. This is a Turing machine. This is not. This is only a finite state machine, and other than coming to final state acceptance, it is giving the output at the intermediate transition. So it is a transducer. They are collectively known as a transducer. Number of states in FSM required to simulate behavior of a computer with a memory capable of storing m words and each length of m. The answer is total combination to mn, and then it will be the power set to the power mn. For every data here, length is n and memory state is defined in terms of power 2. Here the total primary qubit all were Mn and the number of states is 2 to the power n. Yeah, this is interesting. This question is interesting, a little bit tougher. So we have to match the group 1 and with the group 2. We know regular expression. What is the regular expression? By regular expression, you can declare your programming variables, and that is the regular expression. Here you can link it, and the programming variables, any compiler, the first stage is lexical analysis. What does the lexical analysis? Then the syntax analysis. What the lexical analysis does? It gives any variable, comes out any variable, keywords. It gives a token inside it and put it in a particular symbol table. So it is a first phase of a compiler. This is lexical analysis. We just see it here. We just see it. This is the source code. This is the first stage, and it is totally driven by finite state machine. And then it is called syntax analyzer, whether the syntax of the production rules are checked, and it is done by a definitely deterministic Poisson automata. And the output is, I have covered parse tree, today's class I have covered. Then comes the semantic analyzer. This is mainly checking whether integer is putting into floating point into integer. These are the rules are checking. Then the intermediate code generator, machine independent code, then the actually target machine output. Intermediate code, optimization, code generation, these are the stages of the, and then the final is optimization. These are the stages. The first, the lexical analysis, it is totally taken by care of the finalistic machine to detect your variables, programming variables, and generate the tokens and put the tokens in the symbol table. Symbol table is your all the variables, even functions, all of them. So here, regular expression. So answer is here P3. P should do the lexical analysis. P3 is the matched, and then comes Q1. Poisson automata is syntax analysis. This more or less we have covered in our previous classes. And then another is R4. R4 means data flow analysis with code. This is, we have not covered it. Generally, the compiler is the code optimization stage between first stage of intermediate and final code optimization. It is used data flow and register allocation, the final stage of a compiler where you allocate the register, and that is the S2, that is the code generation. Register allocation is linked to code generation. So, it is basically a mixed question between automata and compiler. So this is the question. It is a set of bit of string with even number of which one of the regular expression below represent this. This is, you just by correcting it by example, you see this is the character B. Others are not, others are not taking some of A, C, D. So B is the correct. Thank you.